Melagaro had an assistant, a man named Raulo. If Melagaro's records spoke truly, Raulo offered himself freely as a test subject. With the spike, Melagaro injected Raulo with a high dose of Calibric Extantia, thus gifting the poor man with both endless life and horrific deformity. In honor of his sacrifice to Melagaro's work, the Inquisitor gave Raulo a new name, Fidelitas. I thought Dominus was a leader of vision, of purpose, the man who would resurrect the Eternal Empire. In truth, Dominus is only after power, the black thaumaturgical power locked within the Virtue Gems. He wishes to create a new empire, one in his own image. I drank every night to try and wipe that image from my mind. It's still there. Our expedition made camp in the Western Forest while Piety took a few men through the pass to Axiom Prison. She was after the research notes of one Chevron of Umbra, a witch who devoted herself to the study of transfiguration during the latter days of the Eternal Empire. Piety returned alone and disturbingly happy with her findings. I've learnt that when Piety is happy, misery is soon to follow for everyone else. Go with courage.
You did it. You captured a blackguard. But her head is too pretty to put in a tree. When she's well, I will ask her for blackguard's secrets. Do not fear. She will do this. Females like to do things for silk.
Welcome.
Hello.
Fate awaits you.
On this day, the second Socrato of Verusi, 1334 IC, the Army of Purity remembers its most devout and beloved servant, Archbishop Geoffrey of Frisia. As spoken by Geoffrey, only will and truth can prevail over the evil of our own kin. High Templar Vol, Commander of the Army of Purity.
Fear gnaws at the entrails of the faithful and the faithless alike. Fear of the unknown, fear of the future. An empire requires leadership that can assuage those fears through example, through wisdom, through strength. An emperor lights the way through the darkened caverns of uncertainty.
So that all may find you when the night falls.